Can someone get that man offset?
Oh, he's our morale officer, though.
He is.
He keeps us chirpy.
Brighten up, everybody.
He's like, he's like the running man emoji on your iPhone. Hey, Kip Gamblin knows how to move. He was bitten by the dancing bug as a child. Since then, he's shared the stage and screen with the likes of Kylie Minogue, Christine Arnoux and Barbara Streisand. These days, Kip plays surfer dude turned family man Brad Willis on Neighbours. Let's bring him in.
Yeah.
Hello, Kip.
Lovely to see you.
You're so cool.
Oh, really?
The way you, you know, come walk out, it's really, whoo.
All that dance training, hey?
I reckon.
Kip, meet Ron.
Nice to meet you, Ron.
We, did, we described you in one of the playoffs as a young... As the next Ridge Forester.
Yeah, really? Wow, that's huge. I hope I... can survive TV as long as you
can. I'm sure you're
fine
as
yourself.
That is magical. This could be the beginning of a beautiful friendship.
Oh. Couldn't it just? Oh, wow. You hail from a family of dancers, which
I
think is phenomenal. Did you always expect your career would head in that direction? Or?
Well, I was very lucky, actually, that I think that I found dance. I was a bit of a wayward young man into skateboarding and surfing, and I found classical ballet when I was 14. Which taught me a lot of discipline, so I sort of ran with that and, yeah, went...
You've had a very diverse career, though, haven't you? I mean, there's the soaps, there's your acting role out of that, there's the ballet, you've danced with the Australian Ballet, you were in Moulin Rouge, you were in... what was the other one you were in? The Mal's Last Dancer?
Yes.
I mean, watching you on screen now, you are phenomenal.
God, I haven't seen that for a while. I feel very blessed.
Mm. Was it hard being a kid growing up, like being a boy growing up, because it's not a traditional sort of male occupation, ballet? Was it hard for your mates? Did you get ribbed and stuff?
I think that's the belief most of the time, but I can only think of about maybe half a dozen times I was ever really ribbed about it. And the guys that did, you know, when they saw the gorgeous ballerinas I was hanging out with, it's sort of like they went, oh.
You married one.
I did a lot of musical theatre when I was a teenager, and I know that all the girls thought I was pretty cool.
It's a little bit different.
Because, as you were saying, my goodness, some of the women that you've shared the screen and the stage with, what, Kylie Minogue, Christine Arnoux.
Yes.
I'd have mentioned that you married a ballet dancer.
I did.
So what's it been like sort of sharing the stage with some of these pretty incredible women?
Wonderful. I think, you know, dancers, they're an interesting bunch and we're a pretty tight community. There's not many people that sort of can say they fell in love with their wife dancing around the world, touring Europe. And you know, our first child was a true love child. He was sort of conceived on a tour in Italy.
How beautiful.
That is so romantic.
We do. We still dance together to the embarrassment of our children. But, yeah, we very much so.
What, just in the kitchen?
In the kitchen, at the beach, down the shopping supermarket aisle.
Fabulous.
Yeah.
And you took over the role of Brad Willis in Neighbours. That used to be Scott...
Michaelson.
There you go. I nearly got it.
So how was that? Third actor to take over the role.
Apparently. I didn't realise there was another one.
First Brad Willis.
Right. Yeah.
How was that? Is it weird stepping into someone else's character? Because there's obviously a new Ridge Forrester as well on B&B. And how does that go?
Look, I think when you're walking into a character like that, you've kind of got to run with the new character, you know, and it was 20 years since Brad Willis was on the show, so I kind of made him my own, and he's been to university, he's had children, so we just ran with that.
Yeah, right.
So what's then next? Because with a lot of people, Neighbours and then huge Hollywood careers, and is that where you'd like to go?
Oh, look, to be honest, you know, I sort of like to honour the job I'm in at any present time, and I'd love to give Hollywood a shot. So I'll be looking you up over there, mate, if that's all right.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely one day I'd like to have my chance. I've got a few friends that have gone over there and done quite well, so...
As an actor, as a dancer, or as all of the above?
Yeah, I've got friends working all around the world in both industries.
Well, just quickly, if you are going to get a spot on Bold and the Beautiful, you are going to have to do the long lingering stare at camera. Can you do one for us now?
The long lingering stare at camera.
Camera four would be
awesome. Thank God they're asking you to do it, not me.
Oh man, can't we do it together?
Can we do it? Let's have a stare off.
You go on. You're on.
No, I'm not going to do it actually.
Oh.
No, we always thought it's the have I left the oven on look, you know, which I have a big joke with my friends a bit. So it's sort of the.
Okay. Oh.
did you smell something bad, look?
That's it. I'll try that one.
What's that one?
It's got that. I just smell something.
That one says a lot.
Which never happens in commercial TV.
Dancing. I have such a respect for dancers after I did this Dancing with the Stars in Italy.
Okay.
Wow. And it's much harder than the one in the US, but I learned how dancing. It's just like, oh my God. And you get in the best shape you've ever done. What he was doing with his future wife, I guess, there's an intimacy and stuff that's really the ultimate of romantic. So good on you.
What an amazing career and life you've had so far. And who'd have thought you wanted to be a dentist when you first started growing up? You are the host of the annual Australian Dance Awards, which takes place this weekend at Sydney's Opera House. You can still buy tickets for the awards. All the details are on our website. What a lovely chat you were, Kip. Thank you very much.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.